Hey everyone, Laurel here with a foundational level percents question. So before we get into it, go ahead and pause the video, take a couple minutes, and try this problem on your own. So in this problem, we have a $10 shirt that's being marked up by 30% and then an additional 50%. And we are asked to find the new price of the shirt. So I'm gonna go ahead and write down what I'm solving for, which I always like to do first thing, and then take a quick moment to basically write down what is being asked here myself, just to kind of map it out and get a sense for it. So basically we have our shirt. We are then going to increase it by 30%. And then as if that wasn't rude enough, they're gonna increase it by another 50% until we have our new price here that we are being asked to find. Okay, great. So the first thing we have to do here is increase $10 by 30%. And you might just sort of intuitively know that this is $13. You might not, and that's great too. But either way, let's go ahead and kind of slow this down so that we know what's really going on here when we see maybe a harder question in the future with percents. So to do this, what I'm gonna do is take $10 here and then add 30% of $10 of itself. And now the reason for that is that a lot of problems won't be clear what you're taking that percent of, and it's always the base. And so in this case, it's of $10 again. Now the reason I wrote 30% just like that is because percent literally actually means per 100. So for example, if you have 20%, you can write that like 20 out of 100. And so on. Okay, so let's go ahead and simplify this $10, which is 10 plus 30 times 10 over 100. You can always cancel out zeros. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Then we have 10 plus 3 over 1, which is 3, which is going to give us $13. Okay. So now is the very important part of this problem. You might be tempted to say, okay, great. I took 30% of $10. Now I'm marking it up by 50 more percent. So let me take 50% of $10. And that would be so understandable, but unfortunately it would be wrong here. And the reason is that we actually need to take that 50% of $13. So we're not gonna take it of the original, we're gonna take it of 13. And this is the same reason that we can't just add 30% and 50% and say, okay, we're increasing the whole thing by 80%. We have to go one at a time. That's like when you go to a store and they're having a great sale and everything's 50% off, but then you have a coupon for an additional 50% off. You'll notice that it's actually not 100% off. They don't actually give that to you for free. So same deal here, we're gonna take 50% of 13, not of the original 10. And to do that, we're gonna do the same thing that we did before, which is 13 plus 50 over 100 times 13. Gonna do that out, 50 over 100 is 1/2 times 13, which is 13 over 2, which is 6.5. And that gives me 1950, which in this case is answer choice D. Okay, great. So the thing to really keep in mind here is what you're taking that percent increase of, and keeping a watch out for the temptation to just add them all together, which we actually can't do. So just to sort of show the generalizable form here, you're gonna see this a lot on the test. This thing is increased by that percent. And to sort of show you how to write it in general, if we ever have X is increased by Y percent, The way to write that is exactly what we've been doing here, which is just x plus y over 100 times x. Now, this might look a little weirder than what we've been doing, but it's actually the exact same thing as up here. We had 10 plus 30 over 100 times 10, and down here we have the exact same thing, just with variables. And if this were decreased by y percent, by the way, we would just subtract here instead of adding.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more GMAT Math Spotlight videos from Manhattan Prep, and leave us a comment telling us how you solved this question. Happy studying!